There's a lot of studies about how when children go outside to learn, they can retain more, they're more creative, they're more cooperative, they're happier. So
I have a child's brain, so that should be applicable to me.
Hey Jim, I've been reading about this thing called nature deficit disorder.
Sounds bogus.
Well, I think you have it. When's the last time you were outside of this office?
They said as long as I was working, I could stay in the office.
Okay, keep your phone in your pocket.
I'm fine.
You need to put the technology away. We're going outside. You're gonna look at some trees, okay?
Yes.
Tell John.
Hi, Jim.
Hey, John, I need to just step out for a health-related thing.
It should be fine.
My name is Phoenix Smith. I'm an ecotherapist based out of Oakland, California.
I'm Ariana Candel, and I am a psychotherapist and an ecotherapist.
Nature deficit disorder speaks to our lack of basic ecological knowledge. It's a term that's used in the ecotherapy community when people have not had enough experience with nature.
I think it's actually affecting people's whole nervous systems. We are so cut off from it in daily life.
Nature deficit disorder is not a psychological term that's rated on a psychological scale.
But it's something that you might tell someone they have.
Right.
You don't know how much I want to pull my phone out of my pocket right now, even though I know that we have no service, but it's a treatable disorder.
Definitely, yeah.
Ecotherapy, the way that I practice it, is that I connect your health and your wellness to deepening your connection to nature.
Being in nature is therapeutic. But ecotherapy tends to be more with some kind of a professional that is supporting another person to actually deal with something that's going on for them that's challenging.
How often do you get outside?
Oh, all the time. I was outside just the other month.
In the past 10 years or so, there's been an explosion of research on nature as a health benefit.
Ecotherapy, nature exposure, not something that they teach you in medical school. Do you have a sense of why that is?
They're just not used to it. They don't know how could it help me.
The prescription is get out, you know, get out in nature.
Do you know how people generally react when a doctor says, go spend some time in a park? They say, I want a pill. But it helps particularly that it's something natural, as opposed to appreciating a painting or piece of architecture or a sandwich.
Well, depends what kind of sandwich you're eating.
We tend to be very impatient. We're plugged into our phones to the internet where we can get information like that. Nature doesn't work like that. It takes time for the body and mind to settle into something, so I would encourage you to find a spot. And when you're at that spot, sit there for a minimum of 20 to 30 minutes.
Just 10 minutes even, walking along somewhere beautiful and you can feel different.
The way that I view ecotherapy, it's not just about your own particular issues. That's what people come in with. But what I'm hoping is that I can awaken and raise your consciousness about what's happening on the planet. It's an easy way to support the well-being and resiliency of all people.
I'm just gonna hold your hand and it'll bring you around and have you feel different things.
When was the last time I picked up a rock?
Put your hands out.
Wrapping paper.
That's good. Listen,
cellophane.
Feel it.
Sand from a beach.
Yeah, it's fun to feel things with different parts of your body.
This would be a good exercise for couples.
Yeah, exactly.
In terms of trust, because you could lead me right into a wall.
Sometimes there's a hawk that'll come or you hear a particular bird.
Oh, that would be terrifying. When I was younger and I came out of our side door and there was a nest of robins directly above the door and the eggs had just hatched. And so the mother was in a particularly protective mode.
Ooh.
And swooped down and started making a noise that I never would think a robin could make and was flapping its wings like I could feel them on the back of my neck. And I started running and I ran all the way to the end of the driveway and it was flapping against the back of my neck the whole way.
Wow, yeah.
This has been very enlightening for me. I mean, it was great. I didn't realize how wound up I was.
It was kind of a long appointment.
Jim, can you walk up to the bench?
It's a giant crow.
Come on.
No way.
Dude.
I'm not walking up to that crow.
Can you please stand by the bench? Get near it so you're at least in the shot. You don't have to interact with the bird.
This video is brought to you by Aetna. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you have questions about health in your body, please email us, and always talk to strangers.
Great job.